In this video, we're going to be taking a look at how to create this logo sweep transition inside Adobe After Effects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
And as always, before we dive into the tutorial, I did want to mention that if you're a patron on my Patreon page, I did create a Mogra out of this template. It is for Premiere Pro, so feel free to download it using the link below. If you're not a patron on my Patreon page, consider joining if you want to support the channel. You can get access to this asset as well as several templates that I've created in the past for After Effects and Premiere Pro. But with that being said, let's dive in and see how to create this. So I'm inside Adobe After Effects, and to get started, I'm going to go up to Composition, New Composition. I'm going to just name it Logo Sweep Transition. And then from the preset window, I'm going to select 1920 by 1080, 29 frames a second. For the duration, we don't need it to be that long. I'm going to change it to around 5 seconds or so. Once you're good, you can click OK. And next, what we have to do is import our logo that we want to use. So I'm going to go do that. I'm going to go to the Finder and navigate to my logo. So I have my logo here, and with it selected in the Finder, I'm just going to click and drag it to my project panel. This will import the logo. What we first have to do is set up our animation for the logo in its own composition. So to do that, what I'm going to do is click and drag this to the new comp button, and this will put it inside its own composition. You can see right here, a new composition has been created with the same name as the logo. You can rename this if you wish by hitting return and renaming it, but let's set up our intro animation or our animation for our logo. So in the example, it scales in and scales out. So what I'm going to do is click on our logo, click S on our keyboard to bring up the scale property, and then I'm gonna keyframe it by clicking on the stopwatch. I'm gonna set the first value to 0. And then I'm gonna go forward out in time to around 15 frames, and then change it back to 100. And then I'm gonna go out to 1 second and then change it back down to 0. If we play it back, it looks something like this. Now this is okay, it's very linear, and if we want, we can enhance it by adding some easy ease. To do that, what I did is right click on the middle keyframe, go to Keyframe Assistance, Easy Ease. You'll notice that the keyframe icon changes to an hourglass, and we can even take this a step further by going into the graph editor. If you click on the property, you'll notice that you see the keyframes displayed here. We can easily click on one of the keyframes, and you'll notice that these handlebars appear. What you can do while holding down Shift is you can click and drag these out on both of the sides, and you'll notice that it kind of eases into that keyframe and eases out of that keyframe. So if we play it back, you can see what it does here. It kind of punches in and holds there for a hot second, which is the animation that I used in the transition pack. So once you have that set, we can go out of the graph editor by clicking that button again. And now we can start building it back in this composition here. If we go back to the logo sweep transition, we can start adding in our logo animation to this composition. So to do that, what I'm going to do is just click and drag our logo placeholder into this composition. And if we go out to 15 frames, we can see it fully animated here. And we can just scale this down by clicking and dragging on the edge while holding down Shift to scale down our logo here. Now the size is really up to you. You can make this however large or small that you want. I'm going to adjust my scaling to fit here. That way we can start building this out. But what I'm going to do is just scale this up a little bit here, and then just click and drag this to the top left corner. And we can duplicate this a few times. So I'm gonna click on our logo and duplicate it by hitting Command D, and then just click and slide this to the right. And if we play this back, you can see now we have two animating at the same time here. So I'm just gonna keep doing this. I'm gonna keep duplicating the compositions and clicking and dragging them to the right to kind of create our first row here. So now that we have our first row, as you can see, we have them all spaced out here. Now, if you want to get the spacing down, what you can do is select all of them. So if we just marquee select all of them in the timeline, what we can do is navigate to our Align panel. If you don't see this, you can always go up to Window Align. And what you can do is distribute vertically and horizontally. So we're going to do horizontally here, and this just spaces them out all correctly here. So now if we play this back, you'll notice that they all animate on at the same time. But the one thing I did in that transition or that sweep is that I animated from left to right. And to do that, you can offset the timing in which that they animate on the screen. So to do that, you can do it automatically using a plugin, which I'll show you in a second, or you can just do it manually if you don't want to install plugins. You can just go out forward and time here and say that's the first one. You can click on the second one and then just drag the layer physically to the right a little bit, go out a few seconds, click and drag the next one out, go out a few seconds, click and drag it out, and just do this for all of them here. So we're at 8 frames, click and drag it out, 10 frames, click and drag it out, and now when we play this back, you can see that they're now staggered. So we essentially created our first row. Now just to show you, you can use a free plugin to do this. It's really powerful. I do recommend getting it. I'll link it down in the video description. But essentially if I undo that, I'm just gonna select all of these and hit function option left arrow to snap it back to the beginning of the timeline here. To do this using the plugin, what you can do is go to Window, AE Juice, Shifter. And this allows you to easily shift layers inside After Effects. So if we select all of our layers here, you'll notice some options here. You can change the stagger by doing it in different patterns. So for example here, if I change the frames to 2, to get the same effect we just did, we'll just click on this icon here and click stagger. You'll notice that it does it automatically for us. So that's that effect. But essentially now that we have our first row, we need to build out the other rows. Now what I recommend doing is pre-composing the first row so we have a row of pre-composed offset animations. So just marquee select all of your layers here, right click and go to pre-compose. This will bring up this window. I'm just gonna name it logos row. That way we know this is the logos in the row. Move all attributes into a new comp and click OK. So now that we have this one comp full of logos that animate on, we can simply just click and duplicate this by hitting Command D and then just click and drag this down here. And we can essentially do this a few times to fill in our composition. So I'm just gonna do this a few more times here. You can even use your keyboard shortcuts, shift down arrow to shift them down. And we'll do this maybe 2 more times here. You get the idea. So once we have them all lined up here, what we can do is once again, select all of them and go to our distribute layers under the align panel. So what we want to do is distribute it now vertically. So if we click this button, you'll notice that they all distribute to each other. And for whatever reason, if this isn't working, you can always change this from composition to selection. You want to make sure that you're under selection, not composition. Otherwise, it does it to the whole composition canvas. But now when we play this back, you'll see what we have. And what we can do essentially now is use the plugin to create that arrow effect to the animation. So to do that, what we can do is select all of them, go back to our window AE Juice Shifter. This will open up this window. Once again, we can change the amount of frames to 2. And then we'll select this option right here, the last one right there. This will get it to be staggered in an arrow formation. We'll click stagger, and you'll see what happens here. So this is the final result. And that's how you can create that pretty cool logo sweep animation inside Adobe After Effects. Now, if you want to see how to export this using an alpha channel so you can overlay it on top of footage just like this, feel free to watch this video right up there. I explain how to do that. Now, that does it for this video. As always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.